Welcome, Vasiliki, from the University of Copenhagen, the IT University. We are here, you're hosting the event. It's a beautiful building, compliments.
Thank you very much. You also nice to have such an event here.
You also just shared your story at, on stage. What were you talking about?
Well, basically, what we witness nowadays is a plethora of technological platforms and tools to support open innovation and co-creation practices. So we can think of collectively produced recommendation systems, wikis, open innovation contests, websites and ideation platforms, product development tools, and well, just to name a few. But what the main point is that oftentimes what we witness is instances of openness. For instance, not all stakeholders are engaged, involved and participate in what we want to call openness. So either we just include employees to promote internal open innovation or ask users and customers to participate in co-creating a product or service. So either we have this phenomenon of dealing with a particular user group or with a particular task.
So also when you look at the examples of last days, there are lots of top-down examples. Is that also what you mean with your point?
There are both top-down and bottom-up examples, but the question and challenge is how do we bring them together? And not only at the initial stage of ideation and brainstorming, which is necessary and really cool, but actually how do we move it towards implementation? And more importantly, how do we evaluate and keep all the stakeholders involved after the implementation phase? So how does everyone evaluate how things have been implemented and put into practice?
Can you also give a concrete example? That's like also over here in the university. Do you also use the open innovation over here?
Yes, we do. Actually, with my colleagues at UTECT, which means you are the architect, we have developed a collaborative platform, an enterprise social platform, which is adjustable to different contexts. And one of those contexts is the educational institution, where, for example, I'm using for my course in an effort to educate open innovation ambassadors, which I know sounds a bit pompous, but it's actually trying to involve students in what open innovation means in practice by actually engaging them throughout the learning experience in co-creation practices, in promoting and suggesting ideas, and then see how peer reviewing works, and trying to guide them through how to bring them in reality.
And are you by doing this also inventing the future of education? Because there are lots of discussions about, how will we change education to adapt to the future, not only to the change in needs of students, but also in change of possibilities and technologies?
Well, transformations happen in small steps. And maybe this changing the environment is too big to claim, but actually realizing that we work, think, and live in open ecosystems, and try to keep that in mind in all aspects of our lives, including in delivering education. So trying to bring the companies, the industry, and researchers from all around the world in connection in order to educate young people about entrepreneurship, about what means to be adding value, what social innovation wants to achieve, what it means to make a difference, and how we can achieve it all together, connected, using technologies, but also moving beyond them. So it's not like a panacea, but how do we develop the framework to use technologies in meaningful ways?
Yeah, and it was also because there was also a nice quote, I heard it lots of time before today, about that there are more smarter people outside your organization than inside your organization.
Mm-hmm.
That's also in case of a university. And in what way do you use the wisdom of the crowd to help you to make your organization better?
Well, opening up the boundaries, and this works both sides. So letting students go out, absorb knowledge, recreate it, and present it in new ways. Let them experiment and get their hands dirty in real world and put theories and values in perspectives.
And we also ask from the teachers also to stay connected with the working field and also get dirty hands?
Absolutely. And also, what I'm inviting people is to have a more connected academic community in general. So it's not only students and industries, but also academics all over the world looking at specific research areas that we should be connected in constant collaboration.
Okay, interesting. And do you also practice what you preach, like the software you mentioned? Is it also open source?
It's not open source. Yet, maybe. But it can be openly used by the different stakeholders, like enterprises, social enterprises, and educational institutions can adapt it for free. It's very adjustable and flexible, and without the need of any servers or IT literacy, people can create their own online space.
Okay. So when I want to use it tomorrow, I can use it tomorrow.
Yes, you can.
Okay, I'm looking forward. And what do you think, because what are the main challenges because we're talking a lot about visions and about our thoughts about where we have to go to. Mm-hmm. What do you think, from your perspective, are the biggest challenges in getting to the reality? And when you're talking about open innovation, mm-hmm. how to get it in practice? What are the biggest challenges that we have to get over?
Well, I think that the seed is there, but actually we need to nurture more this philosophy of integrating what is already there and to represent it in new meaningful ways. So trying to make this transformation happen without being hesitant to opening up to whatever that means, not even to dare to engage competitors in co-creating things together. So just to dare and try, experiment, and be open in practice.
Yeah, that was a nice quote. Ever tried, ever failed, fail again, fail better. So I think it's a really nice to process. And what way, because you're dealing with lots of different stakeholders, mm-hmm. and every stakeholder's got his own wish list, mm-hmm. and what way with open innovation can you make the right mix of values by using so many stakeholders?
Well, that was a challenge, and probably I would say that was a motivation for UTech to develop this platform, this tool, how to bring all those people with so different interests in connection. And this is achieved through giving different access rights to all those people and to creating customized spaces for each situation. So there is no all-encompassing like platform that can accommodate everyone's needs, mm-hmm. but people customize it according to their needs. So viewing content, editing content, updating and deleting content really depends on who you are on and what you should see and how you would interact with the others.
Yeah, okay, that's clear. So, and at the end you also had a call for action for the audience. So what did you ask the audience?
Well, I ask everyone to participate in becoming an Open Innovation Ambassador. And I would be happy if someone would like to basically participate in our course here, in the Open Innovation and Design course, by giving a presentation to students, a Skype presentation about success stories or failure stories in the entrepreneurial corner. But I would also like to invite any social enterprise that needs for a platform or a space to promote their values and their missions to contact me, us, our team, so that we can provide them a space to be creative online and to get connected.
And where can I find more information?
You can find more information at udect.com, mm-hmm. and in the TIP website here at the ITU.
Okay, great. Thank you very much. Good luck.
Thank you, too.